everyone, and welcome. This is Melissa Armo with the Stock Swoosh. I'm here today to review the SPY. And it's a good day to do it because I just want to see here how we closed on Friday. All right, we actually closed at 203.23. So this is not right. This is after hours, like Friday night. We actually closed here. So the bar is smaller red. So we opened at 63, closed at 23. So we had a 40 cent loss on the day. I'm really looking at this as neutral. And let me tell you why. Just look at this. Yeah. Wait, 203. Yeah, we closed above this tail. This is crazy, people. I know what everyone's thinking. Everyone's literally, everyone but me is thinking the market's lower. And I don't know what happens with the futures tonight. I don't get futures data. I'm not even going to worry about it until tomorrow morning. But I'm telling you right now, if you just look at the overall trading action here, let's look at the live day. This is the SPY in the live day. I called the market to hold in the morning to rally as a long. I personally didn't do it because I don't buy down gaps. However, I called it for the run. It was a huge trade. Huge! It ran up crazily. Almost got to the dream target. Could have gotten to 208. Okay? It didn't. But it had a huge, massive move. Low in here was 203.39. High up in here was 206.90. Basically ran up to 207. Okay? This is a huge move, people. There's no way around it. More than $3 into the open. Ran up. In the gap down. It was not a gap down to short. I know you look at this and you say, Melissa, this we sold off and we did this and we sold off in the day. Not really. This was a neutral close in the market, no matter how you look at it. The low in here, even in the day, first of all, we didn't even break the low till after 3 o'clock. Then we dropped, bounced off of 202.72. And now that I see this, it even more makes sense. It's the same number here, 78, 72. These are areas. We bounced off the pivot that happened back here in May. Only a month ago. This was May 19th. Today is June 26th. Friday was the 23rd. Or the 24th, it was Friday. Either way, all we did was bounce off this. When I saw the gap in the morning of the gap, I knew to myself we would hold. And we did. And you can say, well, we sold off in the afternoon. No, it's neutral. It's neutral. And this is really bullish to me because of the news that came out, which was the unexpected decision in the morning on Friday from Great Britain leaving or voting. They haven't done it yet, but voting to leave the European Union, the market was topsy-turvy. It was a very wild, volatile day to trade. When I watched this, which I did Thursday evening, Thursday night, I never in my life saw a post-market rally with the kind of volume that I saw into the close on Thursday night. If you were long the market, you made money at the close as long as you get out before this area. But the market was bought hugely into the after hours on Thursday night. Now we did gap down. We hit up to 212 at the high of the post-market area. This is Thursday evening. The vote did not turn out to be the expected vote because they thought they would vote to stay. They did not. So the reaction then was what? Then that the market gapped down. The market gapped down in the pre-market. This is 8 a.m. now. We're talking Friday morning. And so we had a negative reaction. But we just gapped down to support. We just gapped down to support area. And I'm not saying you buy every gap down to support. I'm not saying that at all. I'm saying if I had rated this gap, I would not have shorted it. And in fact, I had zero conviction to short it. Didn't call it as a short. I called it as a long. And that's not something I normally do, but I knew that the move up would be big. And it actually opened and reverse swooshed. And that's something I teach in the Golden Gap class. But the point is, and what I'm trying to say is that everyone that panicked Citi USA, sold out of their IRAs and 401ks and everything else, that was the wrong thing to do because the market is still in an uptrend. It was a news reaction with an anticipation of an unexpected news, and nobody knows these things, okay? Bottom line is the expectation was higher in the post-market Thursday night. It didn't turn out as expected, so we dropped into the open, gapped down on Friday morning, but we held the gap. We even closed neutral. We rallied hugely in the morning of the day. And there's nothing to do with this to the downside, okay? market is still holding the uptrend. It's taking its time to get over the high, that I'll give you that. I mean, I'll tell you that right now. But there's nothing in here that shows a sign of a change in trend. Remember, follow the trend. I didn't make that up. This is just a good rule of thumb, and we're still in an uptrend. Keep in mind, people, that the strategy I trade daily is gaps. I rate gaps. I short bearish gaps or go long bullish gaps if they rate 20 points or more per my 26-point rating system. And this gap on Friday, I would not have shorted. Trust me. If we're going to fall off a planet and collapse into the face of the unknown, I will be shorting everything and then some. I will be screaming short the world, but I'm not doing it. And since I'm the queen of shorts, know that when I say that the actual gap down here, even though it was real, I'm not going to deny it. I'm not even going to say that this gap wasn't real. It was a real gap. And I was upset when I saw it, obviously, because I'm ready for the market to hit over the high for the SPY options I'm in. But I'm telling you right now, it doesn't mean that we won't. And this was a hold. And on the live day, it was actually neutral because the huge rally that came into the open. This, when I look at it, and I'll say one more thing and let everybody go tonight. When I look at this here, this trading action, this is buying, this is buying, 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 buying. And there was buying in the post market. There's nothing that takes away from that. This was buying and this was buying. Now, I know we had a gap down, so you did have some selling or you never would have had the gap down. We would not have gapped down from the previous close. Let's just go very, very strictly to the close in the open. Close Thursday night. I'm not talking about the after hours. Was 210.83. Open, 203.63. So that's basically 210.83 minus 203.63. So it's a $7.20 gap down, not including the post market and the pre-market. From Thursday night to Friday night. So it was a valid gap down to rate, and you could have looked to short it. But what I'm telling you is that it wasn't a short into the open. It reverse swooshed despite that size gap down. And it could have done the opposite. And if we were going to fall off the planet after a gap down like that, we would have done it. Now, I will tell you this. This is a big, big, big week for the market. Who would have thought the last week of the month in June, in the middle of the summer, before a holiday, where the market's closed next Monday, all right, for July 4th. This is going to be a really telling week for the market. I thought we'd run up here and just get over the high. After hours, before the vote tally, we almost were. We gapped down here. I've been talking about this, and I said, could we go down here? Yes. Do I want us to go down here? No. Could we? Yes. Would it change the trend? I said, no. We did it. We did it in a gap. Does it mean we're broken? No. I will tell you, though, this is a very significant week in the market to see where we gap Monday morning, how we trade out, whether the market gets bought, whether the market holds, whether the market sells off. If we have bullish gaps or bearish gaps, and the quality of those gaps as well, and that's what I teach in the Golden Gap class. But I will tell you that, you know, not knowing anything about the futures tonight, not knowing anything about the gap in the morning tomorrow on Monday, not knowing anything at all about the news or what's going to happen next, my gut reaction is that we're going to hold. My gut reaction is that barring any other unforeseen world events, we're actually going to end up holding. We will still make a brand new all-time high in the SPY this year, although I can't predict the timing of that or when. And this thing kind of screwed it up because we almost did it the night before on Thursday. And if the vote had turned out differently, we would have gapped up over the high on Friday morning instead of gapping down here where we did. So anything can happen in the market. Anything can happen. But we will definitely, if we get over the high, have a short squeeze. It's so evident. It's nothing's been more evident. I've been calling it all year. I've been calling it past 2015. I've been saying it. And definitely in the beginning of 2016, I said we're going to see a short squeeze. And it's going to be even worse now because people are bearish on the market. People are scared. People are panicking, but it's not real based on what? Institutional buying. And when I watched the market, and if you watched it too, which probably nobody did, nobody would sit and watch this, just stare at the screen like me. I did. I watched the market trade live on the 1 minute chart and the 15 minute chart in the after hours on Thursday night to see where it was going to go and close. And I'm telling you right now, it was bought. It was being bought. And even this tail thing here is money coming in, buying it. This is institutional money buying it into the gap down and here as well. So, you know, when an institution or a bank or a hedge fund buys into something, they don't immediately quit and sell out of it. And they will buy it at varying prices. They can buy it up here. They can buy it up here. They can buy it up here. Do you understand what I'm saying? So this is the power of institutional money and power money in the market, and that you get in a gap. And I can't wait to see what happens, but my instinct is that we don't have follow through in this gap down that happened from Friday, that we hold this week, that buying comes into the market, and I don't know when we make it over the high. If you're interested in more information on the Golden Gap course, email me at melissa@thestockswoosh.com if you want to learn how to predict what the movement in the market or the SPY or any stock will be. I have a way to do it. It's a 26-point rating system that I teach in my Golden Gap class. It's the way that I train. It's the way I've been able to predict the market. This is a news-related event. The market was long into the open on Friday, and then you should have been done. These kinds of days, you don't want to trade. The market's too volatile, and you almost can't even, you just don't even want it. You just want to watch it, and you can learn a lot from this. And I'm telling you, the market was not bearish. Despite all the negative news, it was not bearish on the live day on Friday. It was actually neutral. We had a huge rally into the post-market Thursday, and we gapped down. This is going to be a big week. I can't wait to see what happens. Email me at melissa@thestockswoosh.com if you want more information. Thanks, everybody. Have a great night.